Dotron, more like Notron.
Dang!
Yes, here we are to talk about, what are we talking about? Rick and Morty.
Morty and Rick.
Rick and Morty, yep, that's right. You've got your main man, Z and Noob Noob here from Our Reviews Will Kill You to go over the nonsense that has become Rick and Morty. Yes.
Season 5, Episode 7.
Yes.
Gotron, Jerry Sis, Rick Vangelion. That had nothing to do with Evangelion.
Nothing.
Stupid.
And Jerry wasn't even in it. I don't think he was like barely.
He was in it a little bit. He had like one good line, I think.
Yeah. So if you want to catch our original episode,
it's number one, baby.
It's number one with a bullet. If you check it out right here, you'll see. You can go back and see why we already predicted that this season was going to be garbaggio. But we're gonna go by this and break down this actual episode, and maybe we can diagnose where things went wrong. And everyone else out there is like, oh, this season's so great. Like, we know, the real fans know that there's something wrong. In fact, when we were looking this up, the original season came out in like 2013.
Yeah, so clearly 8 years ago.
The staff has changed. There's a lot going,
less dicks in the room.
And just, it's not going there. Like, how do you screw up Voltron? They already had a tiny Voltron, if you don't recall. In Reston, Rickslaxation.
There yes. We go.
One of those. And they already had a tiny Voltron. I would show you a picture of it, but I'd have to Google it. And you can see for yourself.
It was an adorable tiny Voltron.
Yeah, and that was a great joke. That was hilarious. Yeah. He's like, no, you can't keep the drones. They form into a tiny Voltron. It was great.
It was a quick scene. It wasn't the whole goddamn episode.
Yeah, so this is a whole, oh man. It's definitely a mix of, they say it's a Goodfellas mix, but it's really Casino and Scarface. I don't really think I saw Goodfellas in there. Maybe The Godfather, but I don't know. Either way, what they're doing now is they're basing entire episodes around one convention, oh, we're going to do a mob joke. And then the entire episode is that mob joke framed within side of, you know, this Voltron thing, which basically it could have been anything. It had nothing to do with the plot, really.
They should have just went to Boob World.
They probably should have just went to Boob World, because that's where the episode starts. And here it starts off with a catchy tune.
I don't even remember the tune, and I watched this an hour ago.
Yeah, it's not funny. And and then there's a joke about Summer being ex-styked.
What?
Which was a combination of excited, stoked, and psyched.
Oh, okay.
Not funny.
I kind of remember that. That was stupid.
I did not laugh once in this entire episode. So we're gonna kind of go through it and see. I think I had an amused smile at one point when I saw the ferrets, when there was multiple ferrets jumping out of all the different places. I thought that was I smirked.
I liked when Morty had to like reach for the ticket to get out of the garage one.
That was yeah. Amusing. Yes, that was amusing.
The struggle
but
he had.
Did you laugh out loud?
Twice.
Okay. Well, yeah. Let's see if we can get to those. So they want to go to Boob World, but they can't. And Morty didn't want her to come, but they brought her because apparently there's more boob empowerment experience, and they need a female to get in for free. So she says, "Oh, I'm like the Coke can that you bring to Six Flags."
And then, yeah, that was another good one. And then Morty was like, oh, but you can't throw out the Coke can afterwards.
I didn't laugh, but it was another amusing. Yeah, it's all right.
I feel like this entire season.
You're going to say you liked the whole thing as soon as we get through
loved
this,
it.
Aren't you? You love this
greatest
episode.
Greatest show ever.
Greatest, yes.
Better than Pickle Rick.
We'll go back to the space jizz one.
Oh, my God.
That's the worst one ever.
That was the best.
Okay, so then the plot gets in gear because
Voltron happens.
Yes.
No, Ferrotron.
They'd stumbled upon a Gotron ferret, and Rick finally gets to do something he's always wanted to do, which is he'll be the only Rick to assemble all five Gotrons, which eventually becomes the Goodfella meets Mech nonsense. Oh, and then there's a little side plot about the voiceover supremacy, which
that was dumb.
So not funny.
They were just talking over each other.
And then
why?
The payoff did not work. There was no good payoff.
Nope.
obviously, yeah, they're saying the final reveal, hilarious, it's a nice touch, is they had
voice-overians.
Yeah, it was so stupid. I can laugh at how stupid it is.
Yeah, that was not.
So they assemble, like, they couldn't even, if you already had a Voltron joke, do you have to make the ferrets?
This,
like,
is a Gotron joke.
But they're dead on, it looks just like Voltron.
But with ferrets. Makes
yeah,
more
but
sense
once it,
when it's ferrets.
Once it fully assembles.
It's ferrets.
You know, I kind of, like, and that's where what I didn't like is there's a good setup for a joke there, but they didn't land it where he's like, oh, it's all going individually and then, it'll escalate one more, you know.
Yeah,
he like wants
dumb.
To make it go full.
Yeah.
Yeah. So anyway, he makes color coded suits for the family, and they
Love
eventually
it.
Get Beth and Jerry to go. Summer just starts like berating them. I didn't think it was funny, and of course they reference
the giant incest baby. That subplot in the end was super stupid.
They need to, okay, I don't understand, with all these characters that they've had over the years, they've had Noob, they've had
I was on the show?
Yes, you were.
Oh,
but
my gosh.
But who else? The Vindicators. Who else has been on the show that was good? Pencil Vester.
Mr. Meeseeks.
They've never really repeated guests. Mr. Jellybean, I guess he might be dead. I don't know. King Jellybean.
Who was the Birdman? He came back a couple times, I think, right?
Yeah, but who was the
Bird Person?
Bird Person. But did he come back? He didn't come back as Bird Person. I guess he was
on
like twice.
Yeah, was a Phoenix Person or something.
Or what's it? Linkler never came back. Abraham Linkler.
Snowball.
No, so none of these characters that are great have ever come back.
Oh, bitch.
But none of them come back, but they're going to have the incest baby not only come back, but come back in the same season.
Yeah.
And it has no lines.
Everybody loves incest and babies.
No, so stupid. So she berates them, makes these makes her joke or
then
whatever
just gets
not funny.
Really stupid. It's like Gotronception, where they just keep making more Gotron bots.
Yeah, he wants to have Gotrons be inside Gotrons.
Inside Gotrons. Why?
But it never pays off.
Don't know.
Yeah, don't know. Why does he want to do that? Nobody knows. So they bring in the mob. They meet the five families or whatever. And this was like yet another. It's like the Citadel of Ricks. Not that exciting. Like, I've already seen this. This is not anything new. I mean, it could have been funny, but they didn't do anything with it. They didn't even have more than like one line.
I mean, Yo-Yo Rick was kind of cool.
But what did Yo-Yo Rick do?
He blew up the one Rick.
So it was Big Fat Rick, Ricardo Montoya, Hothead Rick, and Little Ricky Wrap It Up. Like Big Fat Rick, did you think that joke was funny?
No,
where
that
he's
was
like,
dumb.
They have the same, we have the same size face.
I just liked Little Ricky.
But then he scans his face and he sees, oh my God, they're the same
face. It's an optical
illusion.
Not
funny.
No.
At what point did that was not funny at all?
Nope.
So then I guess, like, that's where it gets weird because they have this operation, but they're not making money. So where's the connection to casino?
I don't know.
Because then they're setting it up like it's a casino, but all they're doing is...
Just has Rick isolating the family one by one.
Yeah, like I don't understand. And Rick's not like being awesome. Like he's not doing anything awesome. It's not like he created the Gotron. Like wouldn't it be cooler if he like assembled his own Gotron that was like made out of scrap parts and he tried to put it in with the rest of the Gotrons? Anything would have been better than what we saw. So then there's an anime crew that comes in.
That didn't make any sense either.
Not funny. Like, did they remind you of the Voltron characters or any characters?
Nope.
They were. I think the voice was Amy from Futurama, but not funny. She didn't say one funny thing.
Yeah.
Then they go, I guess that's the original crew, and like he gets accused of appropriation. I'm like, what is going on? And then Morty gets offered boot bucks. He turns them down, but then they start firing everybody, right? They just start, like, insulting each other and firing everybody, and Summer doesn't know who is who. And then they go into this, like, whole side plot with Summer and the giant incest baby.
That was weird.
And then, like, talk about beating a dead joke to death. They're like, oh, the military came and kidnapped her. And then they wanted to turn it into a weapon, but she bonded with them and helped him escape. And
they
then what?
Need to kill Summer off.
There's way, like, she's a great side character. Like when she drops the line in the one where it's the where they're taking, they keep injecting themselves with their own memories.
Oh yeah.
And
yeah,
she goes, she's got the gun and she's like, oh, did you guys like whatever yourselves again? You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What the hell was the name of it? There was two of those episodes, right?
Yeah, and because she has to like break the thing to find out which plot line she has to do. I thought that was great. So then, I don't understand how anybody could think this was good. But then, how do they fight Gotron at the end? Because it's supposed to be a Gotron inside of a Gotron inside of a Gotron inside of a Gotron. So you're telling me that this space baby is bigger. So then the incest
baby has grown so large that it's bigger than a planet.
It's so stupid.
Planet incest baby.
Which reminds me of Anatomy Park, right? So in Anatomy Park, they have a giant homeless dude who ends up being like, that's like the joke, is they're inside the Anatomy Park is inside the homeless dude. And then they supersize the homeless dude to get themselves out. I guess because they can't shrink themselves anymore. I forget how that plot went.
That was season one in 2013, so.
But the point is, now you've got like, this is the, you know, what are you going to have, a giant space baby? It's basically like they got hired new writers. The new writers watched the old episodes, but like us, forgot exactly what happened in them. And they're like, oh, let's do a Scarface joke. That's funny, right? No one's ever done a Scarface joke before. Look at my little friend. Like, what are you people doing? Why are you doing this? Why are you ruining this show? Like, are you that untalented and lazy hacks that you can't do anything better than this? It's just embarrassing at this point.
Maybe Dan Harmon wanted to put himself in the show and he was Fat Rick, because Dan Harmon's a fat piece of shit.
I don't know. This is another, like, it wasn't an awful episode, but it's just not funny. And it's, frankly, it's boring, especially like a giant Voltron fan. You could do no wrong with Voltron. And you proved it with a tiny Voltron joke, but now, like, I don't even care about the continuity. Like, just make the thing funny.
Well, I mean, continuity is somewhat important.
It's somewhat, but in a world of multiverses and, like, because I know our last video, there's been a lot of conversation around it, and some of the commenters have been talking about how there's a rumor that this is not C-137 Rick.
Sort of makes sense.
Yeah, but then, like, why am I watching stupid Rick? Or, like, why am I watching a dumbass version of Rick?
That would just be Dan Harmon fucking with people.
But for a whole season?
He got his money. Why does he care?
Well, I get it. But, again, that doesn't help us.
Nope.
So, he can go stuff it.
Yeah, there's been two episodes where they put a whole bunch of their family. Because the Mortiplicity episode had a whole bunch of Rick and Morty families, and then this one had the whole family workers. It was stupid.
Yeah, they just keep, I don't know what they're doing.
They keep repeating shit.
Yeah, that's the point, is they kind of go through their old stuff, and then they
but
just repeat.
Yeah, way.
In a worse way. Yeah. Exactly. So I think that wraps up this one. This is another lackluster episode. We'll keep reviewing them as long as you guys want us to.
Because we're sellouts for views.
We are sellouts for views. Help us get to the moon. That's where we belong. So you can help us by sharing the video, by liking, subscribing.
Caring about the video, too.
What would you do to that subscribe button?
Your good-willed intentions do help us. Well, I want you to get the lube, take three fingers, and shove it right in that incestuous baby's butthole.
No, and then smash that like button.
The like button is hidden inside the incestuous baby's butthole.
Wow,
so you gotta go inside a baby, three fingers deep, and like it. Oh, yeah, like it, like that.
No.
Like that. Tap it, then oof, right there.
Well, be sure also to, you can subscribe to our full-length audio podcast. It's free on all sorts of podcast formats. And you can also catch the live stream of that same full length audio podcast. Full length.
Nope.
It's on 7:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time on Fridays. Be sure to catch us there as well. And in the meantime,
Instagram too.
We're
Ork_you.
To the next one.